Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and in this video we are going to review the Resurrection Remix ROM for the Redmi Note 4. So without any further ado, let's jump into the settings and go ahead and do about phone, and let's have a look that it's running on top of Android 7.1.2, that is the latest version of the Nougat, and has the security patch of June 5 as of filming this video. And I've been using this ROM for a while, so I can definitely say that this ROM is one of the most fluent and most stable ROM available for the Moto X Play. And the only thing that this ROM doesn't have is the VoLTE support for the Reliance Jio network. Going ahead into the settings menu, we can see that this ROM is a Resurrection Remix ROM, and the customizations for this ROM are plenty of customizations available for this ROM. And starting off with the status bar, you can customize the status bar if you want to have some uplink and downlink speeds on the status bar. You can enable them, you can change the battery icon, you can shift the clock into the center. And going ahead, you can customize your notification panel, volume panel to your choice, and then you get to customize your recents panel as well. If you want to have the memory bar or the RAM bar in the recent menu, you can have it, and you can change the recent to different type if you want to have slim recents or the omni switch or grid, or I prefer the stock AOSP recent. Then you can customize the quick settings. The most fancy thing I like about this ROM is that you get plenty of option to customize the lock screen. If you want, you can change the bottom shortcuts, or if you can also add some different app shortcuts on the lock screen. And then you can enable gesture everywhere or similar to things, and you can also use three finger swipe to take screenshot just like this. And you can customize the navigation bar or customize the different actions for the buttons. Say if you want to enable the camera app by pressing the volume button twice. And you can definitely customize the animations, which is one of the best feature of this ROM. You can customize the whole animation scheme of this ROM. And then in the interface section, you can change the display size or the LCD density, etc. You can change the font size. Like you can see, I have changed the display size to smaller just because I like to have it smaller so that I can view much more content on this ROM. And then in the miscellaneous section, you have some miscellaneous customizations which you can have a look when you install this ROM. But talking about this ROM, I can really say that this ROM is really stable and you can definitely use as a daily driver. But if you like to click a lot of pictures with your Moto X Play, then I would recommend you to have the Google Camera APK, because the camera which comes with this ROM doesn't do a justice to the 21 megapixel sensor on this ROM. And I must admit that it isn't the best thing for this ROM, that the camera performance is really poor. And it does come with the Pixel Launcher, you can see, and this launcher is being performing really smooth on this ROM. There are no hiccups or etc. And many of you guys asked me that whether there is a quiz to open camera gesture. So no guys, okay, there is a quiz to camera gesture. I haven't used it quite because the camera on this ROM is not really great. So I would definitely recommend you guys to go ahead and flash this ROM, because this ROM is really smooth. The only thing that is the downside of this ROM is that no VoLTE support and poor camera quality. So this otherwise you can use this ROM really nicely and you won't face any problems. So if you guys like this video, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.